guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your girl Shivangi. If you're seeing my face for the first time, make sure you hit the subscribe button, the bell notification button, and of course the like button, because I make a lot of videos on fashion education, my everyday life, a little bit of vlogging here and there, and of course an entrepreneurial journey where I talk about female entrepreneurs and their journey in the fashion industry. So today's video is a special requested video. I've had, I think, more than 100 of you request for this one. And this video is basically all about how I got into FIT. I've already done a candid chatty video where I've taken you through about my journey or my FIT experience. But I realized a lot of you kids had a lot of questions on how to get into colleges abroad, and especially FIT. And since I studied there at their 1 year associate's degree program, I thought this was long overdue, and I had to sit down today and film this video for all of you. So without wasting any time, chaliye shuru karte hain. A quick update: I went to FIT through NIFT Mumbai, and I was there as a visiting student in their special associate's degree program, which was a dual degree program where I studied 3 years in India and 1 year at FIT. But that does not change anything when it comes to getting into the associate's degree. The process, the requirements, everything is the same. And actually, it's a lot more tedious because we also have a lot of portfolio rounds here in India. We have like a sit-down round. First, we are judged for our CGPA. After that, we have like a written test, which is like an objective question paper that we're supposed to answer. And then after that, we have the portfolio round and then the personal interview round. And after all of this is cleared, certain students, in our case, there were around 80-85 students who were eligible to apply for FIT and submit their portfolios to FIT. And after that is when we got to know if you've been selected or not. So the process was a little more cumbersome. But if you're directly applying to the associate's degree program, I'm going to start from where the FIT angle comes in. So that basically starts with when you start to apply. Nothing about their portfolio requirements have changed. Nothing about, you know, all the requirements that they have in regards to the forms, the applications, nothing has changed. It's pretty much standard and the same. So I can safely say whatever information I'm giving out here will help you and benefit you. There are two ways of getting into an associate's degree program, and there are two specializations. I mean, specializations are many. There's accessory design, jewelry design, textile design, fashion communication, advertising and marketing, fashion design. There's so much. I am out of breath, but the more important thing is that either it is a 1 year associate's degree or a 2 year associate's degree. Both the associate's degree programs have similar number of subjects. The only difference is that the 1 year degree is very intense. It is crazy. It's like a crash course of the entire 2 years put into 1 year. So the value of both remains the same, and the knowledge you're getting both remains the same. It's just that this is more relaxed, the 2 year, and the 1 year is a little hectic. Actually, it's really hectic. But if you really don't have the time, or you don't want to invest a lot of time, or you can manage the schedule, go for the 1 year associate's, just how I did, and it worked brilliantly for me. So yeah, when you're applying for your associate's degree and you've decided on the specialization you want to get into, another thing that you need to focus on is that there are two term intakes. So they have a spring intake and they have a fall intake. For fall intake, the deadline is January 1st, but the hard deadline is February 1st, after which there are no applications taken. Similarly, for the spring semester, the hard deadline is November 1st and the soft deadline is October 1st. It's always better to be prepared and get your paperwork done and everything else done and have it in place for, you know, like a month before the deadline. But to each his own, and I think that is why they give you like this warning wala deadline and then the actual deadline. After you've decided which major you want to get into and get your associate's degree in, you have to actually fill up a form at SUNY, which is State University of New York. I'm going to link down the actual website link in the description box so that you can go fill in all the details there and get a hang of how these things are supposed to be done. Well, FIT is actually affiliated with SUNY. It's a state-run institute. It's not like a private institute. It's a government body. SUNY is the big umbrella under which FIT falls. So you have to first register at SUNY. It takes about 7 to 10 days for SUNY to respond to you and give you your ID and password, after which you can access your FIT ID, your myfit.nyc myfit.nyc.edu. Yeah, you can access that only after SUNY has gone through your application and they've seen your form. And once that is done, then all you have to do is focus on getting your portfolio in place, making an application. Again, all of the details on how to go about doing the application form is pretty easy, pretty standard. Once you log in, you have the application admissions bar, which you click on, and then you go into the application. You select the course you want to get into, you select the term you want to get into, and that's pretty much it. After that, you're supposed to make sure that all your documents are aligned. And the other thing which is very important is you need to sit for either TOEFL or IELTS, IELTS, and you have to get in the academic a certain score which ensures that you, you know, your language skills are at par and your English speaking proficiency is at par, and you're eligible to go there and study there, and also you have a good understanding of their language, so you'll be able to undertake the course and fulfill it, complete it, like, you know, nicely. So you have to sit for your IELTS as well. When it comes to your portfolio, that is pretty different for everybody. In fact, for some courses they don't require a portfolio, but fashion design they required a portfolio. And again, the questions, the format is pretty standard. These are the same questions they had the year I sat and created my portfolio, and these are the same questions they had. You need to have a basic understanding and skill set of being able to sew a garment, because they will be checking three pieces of garments that are sewn by you, and your illustration skills is another thing that they're judging you on. So these are all the things that are required in the portfolio, which are all the questions. I'm just going to put them right here. Answered all these questions in a very standard systematic way, you're supposed to upload them on the presentation link that they share with you. There is, I think, a $10 charge now. Back in the day, they did not have that charge, is what I remember. I'm not sure, maybe they had it back then also. But you have to upload all of these documents there. You are also supposed to submit an essay, which is like a statement of purpose. Again, these questions are there, pretty standard. They've been the same questions over the years, and these questions are supposed to be answered in a set way. Your uniqueness, do not copy answers, do not, you know, they take plagiarism very, very seriously. So I would strongly recommend not copy pasting anything standard that you find on the internet. Create your own content. Why you want to go to FIT? Why you want to get into the course? What makes it different and unique? What clicks for you? And also this one question about if you are in a situation where you have a conflict and you are supposed to problem solve it, how would you get out of it? These are all very personalized questions, so make sure that your answers are also equally personal and not something that you've seen on the internet. Once you've done all of this, which is making sure that your portfolio has been submitted timely and has been uploaded on that presentation link, and making sure that your essays are in place, and then sitting for IELTS and making sure you get a decent score, at least aim for a 7 band. They normally have a 6.5 band requirement, but I would still say go for a 7 band. If you've already given IELTS, it should be in the academic module. The validity still should be there when you apply for FIT. And yeah, after this, pretty much you're supposed to wait and anticipate and sit tight and hope that you get in. Once the portfolio round and the essay round is cleared, all you have to do is honestly wait. The results will be announced when they are announced. In my case, the results were announced somewhere in March end or April first week. I think it was March 28th, 29th, if I'm not wrong. And this was for the fall semester. So they take about a month or 2 months time to figure out the results and reach out to you. They also have 2-3 levels. You know, if the first bunch of students reject the application, or they get into other private colleges, or they do not pursue, you know, the course further, then they they have like a second round of screening where they reach out to the next bunch of kids who haven't gotten a chance in the first round, but were the next best. So hold tight, you might have a chance. Don't be disappointed if you don't get it in the first round itself. So after this, after the portfolio round and after you've been selected, all it's gonna take is for you to wait for FIT to email you, because they are very thorough. And when I say it, they're thorough, I mean it. It's not like any other college. They literally take care of their students. They will literally guide you very, very nicely all along the way. They're gonna be there with you. They'll email you about all the details that you need to be worried about, be it right from getting your visa, which is your F1 visa status, which is your student visa, getting your I-20, getting dormitory requests, making sure you take a meal plan or not, helping you select if you want to stay with a roommate of your choice, or if you want randomly FIT to select a roommate, or do you want to stay with somebody who's going with you to FIT, like a friend or something. They'll help you. It's literally a cakewalk after this, because they're very, very thorough. They take care of their kids like no one's business. Their students are their number one priority. I did not realize this until, you know, I got into FIT, that how thorough and helpful they were and how easy they'd made it for every student. Like, you know, the process was so comfortable and so easy, and it was just amazing. It was just amazing how quickly and easily everything worked out. And they're gonna be a little glitch here and there, of course, applying for your US visa, making sure that you get in, because I've had a friend who got rejected the first time and had to apply a second time. So all of that will be a little daunting, but not too much. So I hope this video helps you get a clear understanding of the entire process and how you can go about starting with the process for yourself, because the forms are out. You have until October. I would still say October and not November, but yeah, you have until October, November to sign up for it. And if you get in, I'd be more than happy to help you in the future. And yeah, if you liked watching this video, make sure you give it a big fat thumbs up and follow me and subscribe and do all that good stuff. And I'll see you guys around. Bye.